Bee, this is Sarah Maliski, and I'm here to share with you one of my most memorable memories from college. It all started with my best friend, Ryan. We went to high school together, and in high school, he was that kid who was like always in the chess club and the theater club, would never even think about touching a football or a girl, had skinnier arms than I do, just was the ultimate geek nerd, but we grew up together, so we were just automatically best friends. And so we ended up getting into the same college, and we went together, and it was really cool. So what happened was, Ryan desperately wanted to get rid of this whole I'm a nerd persona, and he figured at college it's a perfect way to do it. No one knows you, you can get out of any previous history that's been written about you. So Ryan figured that if he got into a fraternity, he would be cool because they have like the coolest guys and whatever. So Ryan picked the biggest fraternity on our campus. It had the hottest guys, it had the best parties, they were always paired up with the prettiest girls. They threw the best events, they were all the richest guys, the biggest douchebags, really. And Ryan, though, couldn't get out of his head about wanting to get rid of this geeky persona. So Ryan would do anything to be in this frat. He desperately wanted to be in it. It was really sad, actually. So this fraternity had this one leader. It was this guy, he was really big and buff, and he had blonde hair, and he would always gel up. He looked like a freaking douchebag. And this guy would always pick on Ryan, because Ryan was easy to be picked on. And this guy made these hazing tricks to Ryan. And what these hazing tricks were was having to put hot sauce on your nut sack and go talk to your professors and pretend like nothing's wrong or nothing's on fire down there. Meanwhile, I don't know that feeling, but I assume it's horrible. Another one was having to drink a gallon of rotten milk without vomiting, and oh, if you vomited, you had to drink it all over again. So that was really disgusting for him. Another one was they put him on a dryer, ass naked, and circled in Sharpie all of the muscles he needs to gain and all of this stuff, and he was skinny and he would come to me hysterically crying every night, but he would do it every day because he was determined, and I got sick of it. I wasn't gonna allow this asshole to pick on my friend. So what I did was a little investigating, and I got invited to one of the big frat parties. And at this frat party, it was, you could see it so easily. It was like old rusty carpet with kegs everywhere. There was posters of Pamela Anderson and her nipples out. There was weed, there was drugs, there was beer everywhere. Skunked beer, girls in bathing suit tops, you name it. So I found out where the leader, the big disturbing guy, his bedroom was. And I had to act like, I didn't know where anything was. And oh my God, like I'm so interested in this. Put me in your sorority. Meanwhile, I was like, I'm gonna get you. So I found the bedroom and there was a bathroom attached and no one was in there. And I decided to have my own little frat party in there. There was a Listerine bottle and I got Visine because I saw in movies that if you put Visine in water, it makes you shit everywhere. So I put it in the Listerine bottle. So whenever he would like go on and like hit on a girl and think he was the shit, he would shit his pants everywhere and no girl would want to hook up with you. And then there were condoms in his, behind his mirror, like 18 boxes of like extra large condoms. Meanwhile, probably not. And I put all of my tampons in there, so when you go get a condom, he'd get a tampon, because he's a bitch. Another one was, I got his shaving cream, and I sprayed it all over the place. It was dripping down everywhere, going everywhere. It was like, if you remember like jumpy castles when you were a kid, it was like that, but just with foam everywhere. Another one was, he had these like stupid little slippers in there, and I put them in the top of his toilet bowl, so when you flush it, the toilet water would go everywhere, so it was like a dirty kiddie pool of dirty brown water everywhere. And then last but not least, this is my favorite one, I had hot pink lipstick in my purse. So I put it on, kissed the mirror, and wrote, Ryan, I mean, no, Brian's my friend. I wrote, Brian, I know all of your secrets. Stop messing with us. And then you know what? He never hazed another kid ever again. And my best friend got in the fraternity and then turned into the leader of the fraternity and changed everything around. No one was hazed anymore. Everyone was accepted for who they were. And I feel like I helped that, and I feel like I deserve a little hero award for that. So, MTV, that's my story.